Welcome to the Communication Disorders Research Group here at Edith Cowan University in Perth. We're a team of researchers exploring communication impairment right across the lifespan. Communication is central to everyday life, from reading, talking, texting, emailing, and of course understanding. They're all crucial parts of life in the 21st century. A communication impairment really interferes with people's ability to maintain social relationships with family and friends, develop literacy skills, achieve academically, get a job, keep a job, and also many different aspects of our everyday life, like shopping and paying bills by phone. Our research is focused on clinically relevant research topics and projects that aim to find new ways to assist people with communication disorders to improve their communication skills, but also to improve the effectiveness and accessibility of clinical services. And we're also exploring the best educational methods for training clinical staff in service delivery models. Our team has particular expertise in the area of brain injury after stroke and trauma. And we currently lead large national and international collaborative and multidisciplinary projects in this area. The group brings neuroscientific, behavioural and linguistic expertise to these endeavours, as well as our long experience working in clinical and community partnerships, which are essential in any endeavour to improve clinical services. I hope you enjoy meeting the rest of the team.
My research focuses on early rehabilitation for aphasia after stroke. In Australia, it's very common that most people don't get early recovery and early therapy for aphasia for this condition. Neuroplasticity is not new. We've been relying heavily on ways to enhance neuroplasticity or the brain's natural recovery processes for many years. What our research is doing is helping to enhance people's natural brain recovery processes in relation to language and recovery, so that people who recover from aphasia have a better and improved outcome when they go home. We're focused on improving therapy services and how we do therapy in this early recovery period when the brain's thought to have its best potential for recovery. Our clinical research is heavily embedded in research and healthcare systems around Australia.
Here at ECU, we're leading a team of Aboriginal and non-Aboriginal researchers from across Western Australia, exploring brain injury in Aboriginal populations. Our work involves improving rehabilitation services for Aboriginal people and ultimately improving the brain injury survivors and their families' overall quality of life. We're doing this work in partnership with state and Aboriginal community-controlled health service providers and, of course, the people themselves. We're developing rehabilitation services that are culturally appropriate and accessible to Aboriginal people in urban, regional, rural and remote areas, including telehealth options. And we're also developing the first treatment protocols that can be used nationally and across a range of disciplines.
In order to improve therapy services for people with communication deficits after stroke, we're looking at the range of factors that influence the clinical decision making of the clinicians working with this population. In treating people with aphasia, which is a communication disorder that occurs after stroke, we're finding researchers suggesting that higher levels of therapy provided for a longer period of time is better than therapy provided less intensely and over a shorter period of time. However, in order to make these changes, clinicians are required to prioritise language therapy over a range of competing demands that they face day to day. At ECU, we're exploring the range of factors that influence clinicians' decision making when working with people with aphasia. We're finding there's a range of multifaceted factors that work together to influence the decision making. This includes the caseload prioritisation of the institution they are working with, the range of patients who are on their wards at the time that they're seeing the person with aphasia, research evidence, and patient-specific factors such as their severity, their age, and their rate of recovery. Explicit awareness of these factors is important for understanding the rehabilitation process to improve the services that are required for people with aphasia.
I've been working as a speech pathologist now for nearly 30 years, but I have been researching, been acting as a researcher now in the field for about 20 years. I have a particular interest in how people with acquired communication disorders after stroke or brain injury, particularly aphasia, how those people and their families experience the rehabilitation and the healthcare system. I've also done quite a lot of work looking at how speech pathologists experience working in the healthcare system, so looking at both sides of the story. Particularly, I'm interested in how they negotiate their therapeutic relationship, how people talk about goal setting in rehabilitation, how they negotiate when that rehabilitation is going to stop. So looking at discharge from therapy and how people feel about being discharged, or how the speech pathologists negotiate that discharge decision, process with patients and their families. More recently, I've also been working here with the team at ECU, looking at the experiences of Aboriginal people and their families after stroke or brain injury, and how they experience the health system and their stories and concerns about how we might improve that. So the work that I've been doing in research has really been qualitative. I've been interested in people's experiences, people's stories, and how we can negotiate the best possible service for people with communication disorders. And I've really been driven based on the clinical work that I've been doing, and more recently in the research world, been driven by the idea that our services should be person-centred, that they should be empowering, and where patients and families have an opportunity to have a say in the care that they receive and to feel confident in that service. And ideally, I think speech pathologists are in a good position to act as advocates for their clients, because our focus is communication. And if people have good communication, they're much better able to manage their experiences in the healthcare systems and to have some say and some control over the care that they receive.
Language disorders in children can affect social participation, academic and work performance, and mental health. These effects may not just exist within childhood, but can persist into adulthood unless properly treated. As a researcher in language development in children, I'm interested in how interventions can assist in helping children reach their full potential. While we know that providing intervention early in life is best, we don't always know which children need intervention the most and which interventions are going to work the best. My research so far has investigated a wide variety of populations, including children born preterm, children born with disabilities, and children from culturally and linguistically diverse populations. My aim is to find interventions which suit families, which work quickly, and which help children to communicate well.
Hi, my name is Chan. I'm a researcher and lecturer at Edith Cowan University Speech Pathology. My research interests are in stuttering and speech and language development. Stuttering is a speech disorder. A person knows exactly what they want to say, but they have difficulty with the physical act of speaking. 1% of the population stutter. That's over 200,000 people in Australia. Stuttering can interfere with a person's ability to interact with others and with participation in employment and education. My research aims to increase our understanding of stuttering and to identify and develop effective treatment programs for people who stutter and their families. People who stutter can achieve their life goals just like anyone else can.
Having joined ECU for many years in the paediatric disability field, I'm interested in this area of research. For example, what are the successful factors in the implementation of AAC, or alternative and augmentative communication? My main research area, though, is clinical education, how to enhance the competencies of students before, during, and after their placements. I have investigated the use of videos and e-portfolios to enhance reflective practice. I'm currently investigating professional identity as a key element and the development of confidence and competence in the emerging speech pathologist.
I am halfway through completing my PhD here in speech pathology at Edith Cowan University. I was attracted to ECU because of the experienced research staff in speech pathology and the world-leading research projects that are currently underway. I feel very supported by my supervisors and the broader research team here at ECU. I love the flexibility that a PhD offers. This suits my lifestyle, combining work and study. I feel a part of the speech pathology team here at ECU, and I can pursue my own research interests in aphasia. I hope that my research will provide valuable evidence to guide therapists with clinical decision-making for people with aphasia.